going to do, they're going to introduce themselves and then get us started for the afternoon.
Good afternoon. My name is Kim from Team Viewright. We have a dance group organization for the young teens out here. I'm going to start off by introducing myself. They call me Mama Viewright in the group, AKA his manager. This is my son, the youngest one of the group. And we just out here to support any organization that we can with Stop the Violence, schools, any type of organizations that can help the city of Baltimore, not as well as Baltimore, all over. We travel different places to help different schools and different organizations. So I'm gonna let them introduce themselves.
Hello, my name is Angel. I am Team B. Wright. I go to the C School of Maryland in 10th grade, and I have been with TDR for 3 months.
Hello, my name is Michaela. I am also in Team B. Wright. I'm 16, I'm in the 10th grade, and I attend the C School of Maryland.
Hi, my name is Shamar Wright, aka D-Wright Ma, aka King Ma. I'm 16. I'm from Baltimore, Maryland. I attend Augusta Fowl Savage Institute of Visual Arts. I'm now a 10th grader. And yeah.
How you guys doing? My name is Jermaine. They call me TDL Boosie. I'm 20 years old. I graduated from Bluford Drew Jemison in 2016.
How y'all doing? My name is Sean, they call me Rabbit. I just graduated from Augusta Fowl Savage Institute of Visual Arts. I've been with Team Do Right for 2.5 years and I'm 19.
Thank you.
And I just want to thank y'all for letting us come out, because if it wasn't for this gentleman right here, which was a one-day notice to try to get something together prepared for y'all, the gentleman to my left in the blue, we wouldn't be here right now.
Really appreciate everybody on this. we need to acknowledge a couple more people. And I can acknowledge everyone now, but there's a couple people that without their, what they did was just incredible. And all week long, I kept getting praise. People come to me, I have no idea who they are. This is like one of the best ones. It was organized. The CEO was talking about how lunch was organized. I was like, lunch? Like, yeah, it's like, no. It's complicated. So this is not possible without my help. Help from Jen Dahl. And my event planner, Casey Mangold. So, as we bring this week to a close, we started on Monday and talked about these 42 words that did three very powerful things. They created focus or clarity. They created urgency. They created ownership. It is possible for 100% of our students to be able to analyze a piece of complex text and develop an evidence-based argument and be able to communicate with confidence and conviction. You actually had a chance to see that yesterday with Xavier Plater. It is possible, and it's possible because of the people here in this room. That's why I feel so confident that yes, 100% of our students, 82,354 of them are on track to reach this goal. They're just on their own track. So if we're serious, when we talked about yesterday, if we're serious and we believe and we trust that that relationship that we build between two people, the adult and the student, and our actions do matter, they will either enhance or the opposite. Urgency, focus, and ownership. We've heard a lot of good feedback about what was going on in the rooms today. And we know it was a lot. That's how I know everyone's tired. I was tired just watching, so I know you were tired doing and being a part of it. But I really wanted to, it's not even about me right now, what I really want to do is bring people up here and share their experience. So I'm gonna call some names up. I'm gonna bring them all up at once. Don't be shy. Nick Amar Mosley, Gwynn Falls, principal of Gwynn Falls. Can you come on up? And Carmilla Carnes, Joseph A. Bristol, principal. Laura Hartman, teacher Hollenberg. Daryl Kennedy, ILED. And you may not know this yet, joining them, last but not least, our new director of mathematics was pepped just earlier today around 12:30 p.m., Beth Savvy.
Me that popped this week was just realizing that we have a pathway that's clear, that's distinct, and there's a true end goal in mind. One of the things that is relevant for me is the whole child piece, where we're looking at a culture of children that are suffering with many different ailments or have faced many different types of trauma. So for us to be a district that's focusing on the whole child is important. And you're seeing it with the children that are able to perform, to speak to you, to stand before you, and to express themselves. So one of the things that I would like to see moving forward are more opportunities for our children to have panels where they can communicate with us as leaders and teachers, so we're hearing their voices. And one of the things that I'm asking is not just the high school, but our primary and our middle school as well. Because if we look at this data, thank you, it shows that our third graders' reading level determines whether or not they may potentially be in prison or the type of crime. So if we're hearing their voices from the beginning, then we can start planning from the beginning. So that whole child piece is very crucial for me.
Good afternoon. I had a chance to work with the talented tech, CLN 10. So I know that Star calls her CLN the grade 8. We got to call her as a name too. So I had a chance to work with the talented 10 this week. And my experience this week was about the conversations. And I told them this before we came down here. The conversations that I witnessed this week was at a level that in my 5 years as an instructional leadership executive director, or whatever we've been called over those years, I saw a different level. And it started when we were dealing with the literacy and the writing part, and we talked about how when we did that writing exercise, the expressions on folks' face, but you saw the peer editing, and you saw the conversations that occurred between principals, that occurred between partners, and that occurred between IoT teams. So that conversations during that and the Eureka math part was very powerful. But then we moved to the coaching aspect of it. And it was principals and assistant principals who filled in, working and supporting and pushing each other, because it became less about the process and the cycle and more about what it means to push people. So you had conversations around, you know, who needs to be coached and why do they need to be coached and what does coaching mean and how to coach and evaluate at the same time. So those conversations among those principals and those leaders was just as important. And then finally, at the end of the day, we had teachers talk about their experience at the differentiated sessions. And they had a chance to share with the group how powerful the GAL sessions were, and the college and career sessions were, and the other sessions. And it was just good to hear and see the folks in the room learn from each other and listen from each other. So, you know, I think for my week, the thing that sticks out is the conversations that occurred between the principals and how talented and blessed our whole network, and I know it happened across the other networks, were with the discussions that occurred.
So I just want to say it was amazing to watch all the hard work unfold. I want to thank my hardworking, dedicated, strong team, because it wouldn't have happened without them. When we think about the hard work we did this week and the leadership that you all provide us, the feedback that we are getting right now and moving the work forward is what's going to make the difference. So when we think about, Sean keeps saying urgency, focus, ownership. When I think about that as the work moves forward in mathematics, when we talk about ownership is we need to own that Eureka curriculum. How are we going to make sure it's getting implemented with fidelity, and how are we supporting our teachers and our students through that? And then we get to the next piece around focus. It's maintaining that focus that we've had around the instructional core, looking at that task and making sure the teachers are understanding those student math practices and the teaching practices, and how do we help them grow as we're building the knowledge of our teachers and our students. And lastly, urgency. We know there's an urgency around professional development for teachers. We hear it loud and clear that they need the support, they need to practice what they're teaching, and they need to work together so that they can focus on adapting those lessons for students. So that's a lot of work for me, as I've just been thinking about that for the last 2 hours, right? But I'm excited, and I can't wait to hear from each of you. Anything you have, share with me, share with my team, so that we can get better. Thank you.
So the big takeaway for my team was day two, when we actually kind of went through the learning as a lens of our students. It kind of opened my eyes to the challenge that our students experience within the classroom. And so next steps for my team is I'm going to go back to make sure that our teachers are getting a rich understanding of the materials and what is that going to look like for each individual learner in my building.
So a big takeaway for me was the planning aspect. I think many times throughout the year I asked my lit ACL, well, like, why wasn't this planned? Why haven't we thought through this? And now we have a full year-long plan for literacy and for math, and I know to plan for my collaborative plannings what I need to do and what is coming from the district. So I find that very helpful.
Just one more point. One of the things that we really talked about this week was the academic discourse. And I'm not sure if you experienced it in your session, but one of the things we experienced was not enough time. We got into great discussions and great discourse and great conversations, but then we had to move on. We had to get to the next slide. We had to get to the next point. So keep that in mind when you go back to your schools and your teachers are going through the same thing. First, get comfortable with being uncomfortable with having noise in your school, as long as it's productive noise. Secondly, be mindful of your teacher's pacing. So allow them time to get into this or discourse and conversations that will lead them to the end goal of that writing product. So just be mindful that it takes time to have a conversation. We don't want to stagnate our children from expressing themselves because there are time limits and there are guidelines that we need to meet. So just keep that in mind as we move forward.
Woo! Thank you, everyone. Thank you. So, my last thought is just like I did in August of 2016, it's my commitment. When I say my commitment, it's not just me, it's my entire team. Four things we promised about the year, four things that you can hold us accountable to. Meaningful voice for leaders, teachers, students, increasing professional growth opportunities, utilizing data to inform district strategy and align supports, and addressing the needs of the whole child. I'm just gonna briefly go through them quickly. So even today, we pulled a group of principals and teachers and allied these into and had lunch with me just to understand their point of view. They only gave you a little tiny piece of what they shared with me. But I wanna make sure that you all have a voice in this process, because it's the only way we're gonna make sure that 82,354 students are on track to meet this goal. So we are committed to making sure that you all have many opportunities to express and share what you think and what we need, what you need to move forward. PD throughout the summer, please continue to work with your teachers to sign up for this. We have our literacy and math institutes in July. We have our special education institute in August. And then we have other learnings throughout the summer, other learning opportunities throughout the summer. And then our leadership series, we haven't talked much about that. You should get an email, leaders, you'll get an email over the weekend about this. And I believe it starts the second week of July. And here's actually a brief schedule of what it would look like. So on July 12th, we'll have professional development or learning opportunities from the whole child office, finance, chief of schools, OAA, which is achievement accountability, our data systems, and operations. We'll offer multiple sessions throughout the year. We know you're taking vacations, so it'll be the same sessions run over and over again. So if you want to join one and you say, well, I'm on vacation at that point in time, you'll be able to catch it at another point in the summer. Here at the Baltimore Design School. Professional development, I know there were some questions about this around when we go back to school. We have 4 days before our students return. Two of those days are gonna be completely school-based, how you feel and want that those 2 days to go. The third day is also at the school, but we're gonna be starting with what you learned here. So 2 days, your choice. The third day, we have an agenda for you. And then the fourth day, we will actually be pulling teachers throughout the district to different professional development opportunities. And then on the right-hand side, you have our PE days, which I'm sure you already know throughout the school year. All this stuff's on 365, so I see people taking a picture of it, but you'll be able to get this. Data, just committed to making sure we look at data differently and use it differently. And as we want to get the voice from the field, we do want to know what schools in quadrant one are doing, even what schools in quadrant two are doing in quadrant three. So we do want to pull people and, you know, pick your brains on how what you're doing and how we can do things better, and just make sure that we are consistently using data differently. One of the things that we are working on right now, and hopefully we'll have it ready by the beginning of the school year, but if not, it'll happen, you know, sometime in the first half of the school year, is we are thinking and looking at how do we bring an assessment that is more standards aligned, as well as aligned to our curriculum. Addressing the needs of the whole child, I was completely amazed at how yesterday was received, especially Dr. Williams at the end of the day, the amount of emails that were saying, please keep pushing this is what we need,
push this conversation, one principal walked up to me, and I can't quote what he said, but it was almost like, I have to go home. I have to think about what just happened here today. This was a lot, and I have to process this and what this means for me and my job and how to move forward with the school. It was just really powerful to see how that was received and where this can go. I'm thinking about how this flips everything we've been thinking and everything that we're going to do. And really, it's all about the goal is whole child and how everything else we do is in support of that. That video, I watched it again last night. I'm just leading with what I said yesterday. As you're planning the summer, as you're working with your teams, just every now and then pause and think back. What are you explicitly doing so your students know that they can and know that they will? I want to thank you all for a great week. I want to thank BDS for holding us. Principal, you've been great. Thank you very much. I know many of you are getting ready to take your vacations. Go take some time and enjoy. Those of you leaving tonight, be safe. I'll see you throughout the summer. Thank you, everyone.